Hi friends, welcome to the session on WebLogic 12c. So today in this session we'll go ahead and we'll look into the OPatch. Coming to WebLogic 12c, the BSU utility has been removed and they have provided us OPatch utility for installing the patch, and you can apply the patch using this OPatch utility. And this is a common utility for all other middleware products also. So earlier in WebLogic it was a separate utility with BSU, and so now it has been merged. So now we use this OPatch utility to install the patch, and we also use it to apply one or more patches, roll back the patches, detect conflicts among incoming patches and between all those things is done through OPatch. So whenever you are doing a patch, the first thing you have to keep in mind is that you have to bring down all the services. So you should make sure that nothing is running, because if some of the processes are running, in that case your WebLogic, your patch may fail, and because some of the resources which it requires will not be available. So in order to apply patch, you have to go to Oracle and go to your Oracle home, and here you will find the folder as inside OPatch. You can see the find folder as OPatch. Here you have the OPatch command. So this is the command which we will be making use of it, and this will tell us to apply the patch. The first command which we will see is .opatch version. So we will know the version of the OPatch, because we will make change on the OPatch also. So it is the latest version, OPatch version 13.9.2.0.0, and this is the latest version of the OPatch. Now the next command which we can run is if you want to know what all parameters are there with OPatch, you can click on /opatch-help. And it will show you all the parameters which this OPatch is going to I have to give a hyphen also, but it gave me the output whatever was required. So you can see here it is the, these are the properties which we can use OPatch apply. Apply is to apply a patch, and apply to apply multiple patches, rollback to roll back your patch, roll back multiple patch, ls inventory to see how many patches are there, ls patch is to see what all patches are available, and few others prerequisites to see how it will behave. And so let me go ahead and get one of the patch applied on this. So the first thing is, let's see what patch are already applied on this. So ls inventory, so patch ls inventory will give you the output as which all patches has been applied. So you can see there are already 4 patches which were applied after the installation. So these are the patch ID is this, these are the patch which has been applied, and 4 patches have been applied on this WebLogic 12c. And here you can see the home which it has selected. So make sure that you select the home. If you have multiple home, so you have to make sure that the correct WebLogic home is selected. So here is the output. So if you want to redirect the output in a file for to send it to some person or Oracle support, you can give the file name here. opatch.log.txt, whatever you want to give, and then the log file will be created. So this is one way. So here one file will be created. You can download this file and provide this file to the Oracle support or to the person who is asking for logs. So it will give all the details about your which all patch has been already applied, and which patch is if the patch which you are going to apply is present or not. So this is one of the command which you can use. Another command is the same, opatch ls patch will also give you the same type of output. Let me show you. opatch ls patches, it will just give you the patch number. So you can see it is just giving the patch number, not the complete details which are the bugs, fixes and all. It is not giving me those details, but yes, you will be able to find the patch number here, which all patch has been. So ls inventory is the most used command for opatch. Now I will be applying a new patch on this, so this on WebLogic 12c. So for that I will go to the location where my patch is kept. So it is in the new patches 12c. So I downloaded this patch from Oracle support. So there are two patches which I have downloaded, 2189. So this was a jar zip file. I unzipped this file and this folder got created. So I can go to 2189. So I can go inside here and these are the files. And now if I have to apply the patch, I will be inside here and I will go to Oracle 12c WebLogic opatch and patch apply. So opatch apply, if you run this command, it will apply the patch on your WebLogic. So on your WebLogic it will apply the patch. And if you want to see before applying, what you want to see the report, like if it is correct or not, if the patch will create a problem or not, you can run this command, opatch apply hyphen report. So this will, this command this command is not gonna apply the patch, but it is just a simulation. So it will see, it is just a simulation and it is showing that the patch is, see, it showed me that this patch is not needed because 218967 from the patch list, this patch is not needed after skipping. So it will tell me the information upfront if this patch is required or not, or if this patch is already present. So it will do a test and then based on that text I can give my things. So let me try here. I don't think so it will be applied because this is a newer version, all the patches are already applied on this. So this patch is also not needed. So let me see if there is any patch for this version. I will download that and I will be applying that patch on this. So I checked on Oracle website and there is no new patches has been released for 12.1.3. So let me apply this patches which I have downloaded in my 12.2.1.3 version. So let me go to that location. So I will be applying the patch on the another version. So let me, so here my MFT, I will apply it on my MFT home. Opatch, it is also there, opatch apply, you can, and then you can give a report so that you can see if the patch is required or not. Before running apply, you should run this report so that you will be able to understand if this patch is required or not. So you can see, yes, this patch can be applied on your this, you have to give the why. So you can see here, there it is just reported here but not performed. So it is just showing you the output, it's not doing anything right now, but this patch can be applied on your Oracle MFT home. This is also a WebLogic home which I have used for other product installation. So this will not apply the patch right now, the command which I have used, it is just showing when it will, it's just the report, it is just showing me that it will do perform all these activities and then it will apply the patch. So these actions are reported, so you can just have a look on these actions before applying a patch on your real-time environment. And then you can, as you can see, the patch was successfully applied, user request. So this is just, it is showing me anything, but it has not applied the patch. So if you want to apply the patch, you can just remove this report and opatch hyphen apply. So this is the command If you use this command, make sure that your WebLogic servers on this environment is down, and it will check the Oracle home error code or patch failed. Please do check failed. So there is some problem with this. There is class does not exist. The problem in this particular patch. Let me go to the other patch which I have. Let me see if we are able to apply that patch. So multiple patches are there which are not required, or which will be used only for few components, or that patches are already included, then those will give you a error message. So here you can see this patch and the another patch which is another 12c patch 1218191. I am trying to apply this, so it is trying to see what is the do you want to proceed. You will give yes, and then please shut down Oracle instances running on running out of this Oracle home on the local system. So it is asking you to shut down all the Oracle instances or the admin managed servers which are running on this making use of this Oracle home before proceeding, so that once if that's all the systems are down, then you can respond with why, and then it will take some time to apply the patch. So now you can see the patch has been successfully applied. So this patch was successfully applied on my WebLogic. So if you want to see the output ls inventory, you can give the ls inventory output, and we'll see this is the number 218 which we have applied ending with 691. So we'll check in our ls inventory if that 619 is applied or not. So you can see here this is the patch ID. You can see applied on Tuesday 5th December, and the time is also required here. So you can see here, and it fixes one bug. So here you will be able to see the details. So ls inventory will help you to give the output which all patches are applied. So now if you want to remove a patch, you can use opatch rollback, and then you have to give the ID. So let me remove this patch which I have applied. So let me, again I will use the same command opatch, and let me so rollback, and then I have to give the ID. So the ID will be, let me give this ID which I want to, which I have applied. So 21 paste, and then you press enter. Again this opatch will remove this patch from this middleware home. So you can see rolling back, it is doing a rolling back, and it is removing the interim patch 2189761. So it will remove the patch from your. So this is how to apply the patch and to remove the patch. If you have multiple patch, you can use napply. If you have multiple patches to remove, you can use this and rollback ID. So these are the commands which you can use to apply and remove the patch on your 12c inventory, and it's really very easy to patch your environment, and it takes less amount of time compared to 11g version where it used to take more time to apply the patch. So it will remove the patch from here. In the meantime, let me I'll provide all these details, all these documents will be paste along with the video. So you can see the patch succeeded, it has removed. So now if you want to see the ls inventory, you will not find this patch ending with 691 in the output. because that has already been removed. So now only 8 patches are there, and that patch which you were seeing in the previous output has been removed. So this is how to apply and remove the patches on WebLogic 12c. I hope you are able to understand and make use of this opatch to apply patch. And commands are here. There is, let me show one more command, oracle mft opatch, and here you have bin and you have one command list domain patch inventory.sh. you can run this. It will show you here you have to give the domain name here, oracle mft user projects domain mft dev domain. So it will go and check, no patches were found in this domain inventory. So it will check the domain location and it will check if the patch has been applied or not. So first let me apply the patch and then we'll see. CD media sf score new patch 12c. So we were 9, which patch we have applied, let me check, 691. Let me apply that 691 CT21691 and I will use the same command, opatch apply. So I will use this command, opatch apply, and then this patch will be applied again. So yes, if your local system is ready. Yes, my local system is ready. So make sure that you shut down your servers whenever you are doing this patching on your environment. So it relatively takes a very less amount of time compared to 11g version, and that BSU utility in the GUI mode, it takes a lot of time, but this one takes less time. And every quarter WebLogic releases the patches. Let me show you that you can you should keep your system updated with the latest patch. Patches here you can see October 2071 patch was latest patch were released. So every you can see the next patch is going to release on 16 January 2018, another is 17 April. So whatever is identified, whatever issues are identified, they are bundled and they are they give the patch every quarterly for us. So this is the for each and every product, it's not only for WebLogic. So there are so many products, Oracle products, so for all the products they will give us the patch. So you can see WebLogic server 12.10.36, 12.13, 12.2, 12.2.1.0, 12.2.1.2. so this is the last version because this version is released recently. So you can see which all CVEs has been fixed. So all CVEs are, they have their rank. So 9.8 Oracle WebLogic security related one, 9.8 CVE was fixed in this patch, and which all are the affected versions. So all these information, so you should always keep your environment on the latest patch so that there is no new vulnerability, or if the vulnerabilities are there, they get fixed automatically. You do not get a report from your management or from your team that one of the critical vulnerability has been found and then you have to patch it. So if you keep this and if you keep your WebLogic server instance with the latest patch set update, those risk will those vulnerability report will not, will be already been taken care, and then those reports will be green for you. Otherwise it will show a red mark that this vulnerability and this has this score and all will be there. So 10 is the highest score, and if it is a 10 score vulnerability, they will try to patch it on within 1 or 2 weeks, and it's very critical. So whatever is the base score, this will tell us how big this vulnerability is. So I will provide you this link as well. which you can use it for your to check every quarterly when the patch is getting released, and then make use of it. So the patch has been successfully applied. Let me go to Oracle MFT opatch bin. Let me use the same command. Yeah, so it will show me list domain patch inventory and this command cd bin, and then we can run that dot slash ls inventory. This will show me the patch has been successfully applied or not, so all the information will be there. So this is the most important commands which you should remember for patching. So 9 patch were applied, and this is the last patch which got applied, and it was applied on 5th December. All the informations are here. So hope you understood how to apply patch on WebLogic 12c. Thank you.